Good morning, students. My name is Mandeep Kaur from California Public School. Hope all of you are fine. Now let's start today's topic. We are doing the fifth chapter. The name of the chapter is Complex Number, and today we will discuss a new topic, that is the cube root of unity and its properties. Now, firstly, what are the cube roots of unity? That means what are the cube root of unity? What are its roots? Unity, that means 1, and its cube root. And we have to find what are the roots of this cube root of unity. So let's start. Let us take that is equal to x. Let us take that is equal to x. Now here is cube root, that is the symbol of cube root here. So firstly, you just have to do cubing on both sides, because whenever we have square root here, then we will do the squaring. If we have cube root here, then we will do its cubing on both sides. So firstly, cubing both sides. So in this side we have x cube, and in this side we have only 1. Now here is plus 1, in this side it will be negative. So x cube minus 1 is equal to 0. Now use the identity here, a cube minus b cube. I'm going to write here a cube minus b cube, that is equal to a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. So use the formula, the value of a is x and the value of b is 1. So put the value here, firstly a minus b, that means x minus 1 into a square plus ab, that means x into 1, that is x, plus b square, that means 1 square is 1, is equal to 0. Now x minus 1 into x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0, that means either this one equal to 0 or this one equal to 0. So here we have x minus 1 equal to 0 or x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0. From here the value of x is 1. So our 1 root is 1. Now from here is a quadratic equation, and we have to make its factors. So use the quadratic formula to make its factors. So firstly, I'm going to write here the quadratic formula. Quadratic formula for the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The quadratic formula is x is equal to minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac over 2a. So use this formula here. Here the value of a is 1, b is 1, and c is also 1. So put the value here, x is equal to minus of b, that means minus of 1 plus minus root b square. I'm going to write here the value of a is 1, b is 1, and c is also 1. The coefficient of x square is the value of, a. The coefficient of x is b, and the constant term is c. So firstly, x equal to minus of b, that means minus 1 plus minus b square, that means 1 square minus 4, a is 1 and c is also 1 over 2, a is 1. After that we have x equal to minus 1 plus minus, here is 1 minus 4, that is minus 3 over 2. Now I'm going to rub this. Okay, now we have x is equal to, here we have x equal to 1, and from this side we have x is equal to minus 1, and square root of minus 3 can be written as under root of 3 iota. So here is plus minus root 3 iota over 2. That means the other values of x are minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2, and the next is x equal to minus 1 minus root 3 iota by 2. So the cube root of unity are 1, minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2, and minus 1 minus root 3 iota by 2. These are the roots of cube root of unity. Because here is the cube root, that means the value of x, three values of x exist, first, second, and third. Let us see, here is x equal to 1. The first one is this. Let us say that is equal to any symbol, that is omega. Let us suppose that root is equal to omega. You just have to represent this by the symbol omega, that is called omega. whenever you will do it scaling, then you will get the value of this one. When you will do it scaling, you will get the value of this one. That means that is the value of omega square. So the cube root of unity are 1, omega and omega square. These are the cube roots of unity. Omega is equal to minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2. When you will do it scaling, use identity and you will get this value. That means this is the value of omega square. I'm going to explain this again that you can understand it easily. Firstly, we have to find the cube root of unity. That means cube root of 1. Firstly, cubing on both sides. After that, here is plus 1. In this side, it will be negative. Use the identity. After that, you can get the values of x. Here is x equal to 1. And in this side, use the quadratic formula. Minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac over 2a. After that, you will get these values. And that is called the value of omega. And when you will do it scaling, you will get this value. That means that is omega square. So, the cube root of unity are 1, omega and omega square. Let us suppose that you have to find the cube root of minus 27. Let us suppose you can find out the cube root of any number. Let us suppose you have to find out the cube root of minus 27. Then in which way you have to solve this one? X equal to minus 27 and its cube root. In the same process, cubing both sides, after that use the formula, after that in this side you have to use again use the formula, and in the similar way you can find out the cube root of minus 27, and in this process you can find out the cube root of any number. Now let us discuss the properties of cube root of unity. Okay, now the properties of cube root of unity are, what are the properties? The first property is sum of cube root of unity. Sum of cube root of unity is zero. That is the first property. Now, what are the cube roots of unity are there? 1, omega and omega square. And the property say that it's sum. That means 1 plus omega square is equal to 0. That is our first result. I'm going to prove this one also. Firstly, write the value of omega is minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2. And the value of omega square is minus 1 minus root 3 iota by 2. So, put the value here. Here is on the left hand side. Firstly, is 1 plus the value of omega is, here is minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2. Plus the value of omega square is minus 1 minus root 3 iota by 2. After that, LCM is 2. So it becomes, here is 2, here is plus minus 1, here is plus root 3 iota, here is minus 1 and here is minus of root 3 iota. Look at here is positive root 3 iota and negative root 3 iota, both are cancelled. Minus 1, that is minus 2. So 2 minus 2, that is 0. So 0 by 2, that gives the answer 0. So the first property says the sum of cube root of unity is 0. That is very important, because in your worksheet you have a few questions that you have to use this result. Let us suppose you have given in the question 1 plus omega, then you can directly put the value of 1 plus omega, that is minus omega square. In a few questions, you have given 1 plus omega square. 1 plus omega square, that you can directly put the value 1 plus omega square, that is minus of omega. So that property is very important. Now for the second property, the product of cube root of unity is 1. The second property is product of cube root of unity is 1. That means its product 1, omega, omega square. Its product is 1. And the similar way you can prove this property also. Put the value of omega and omega square. After that you have to do its multiplication and you will get the answer 1. So from this property we have the next result. That is the second property. Product of cube root of unity is 1. From this one, we can find out omega into omega square, that is omega cube. So you have to use this result also in many questions. Omega cube, the value of omega cube is 1. Let us suppose we have to find out the value of omega raised to power 7. Let us suppose we have to find the value of omega raised to power 7, in which way we can find out, we know the value of omega cube only, and it can be written as 3 2s are 6 and here is 7 completed. Similarly, in the process of in which we have solved the values of eta, the powers of eta, the value of omega cube is 1. Here is omega raised to power 7. So write in this way, omega cube, its power is 2, 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7 is completed. Now the value of omega cube is 1. So 1 square into omega, that becomes omega. So the value of omega raised to power 7 is omega. In the similar way, you can find out the different powers of omega. Omega raised to power 15, 17, 20, so on. Now, from this result, we have the another properties here. Omega cube, it can be written as omega into omega square equal to 1. So we can find out here from the value of omega also, that is 1 over omega square. And similarly, the value of omega square is 1 over omega. These results are also to be used in your worksheet. Now let's start a few examples related to all these questions. Now come to the next one. Now, given that 1, omega, omega square are cube root of unity, and you have to show that 1 minus omega plus omega square, its power 5, plus 1 plus omega minus omega square, its power 5 is equal to 32. Firstly, look at here. We have given that 1 omega, omega square are the cube root of unity. That means we have to use this result, omega cube equal to 1, and 1 plus omega square equal to 0. In the maximum number of questions, we always use these results when we have given that these are the cube roots of unity. So let's start from its left hand side. Its left hand side is 1 means omega plus omega square, its power is 5, plus 1 plus omega minus omega square and its power is 5. Now look at here. Here is 1 minus omega plus omega square. 1 plus omega square, we can find out the value of 1 plus omega square from here. So use this one, 1 plus omega square, its value is minus omega. So put the value here, 1 plus omega square, its value is minus omega, and here is minus omega as it is, and its power is 5. Similarly, 1 plus omega, we can find out from here the value of 1 plus omega. So here 1 plus omega is equal to minus of omega square. So use this one. Here is minus omega square. Its value is minus omega square. And here is minus omega square as it is, and its power is 5. Now minus omega, that becomes minus of 2 omega and its power is 5. And here is minus of 2 omega square and its power is 5. Now here is minus 2 raised to power 5. That means you have to multiply 2 5 times. It becomes minus 32, and here is omega raised to power 5. Similarly, we have minus 2 raised to power 5, that is minus 32, and omega square and its power 5 becomes omega raised to power 10. Now from both these ones, we can take minus 32 omega raised to power 5 as a common, and it becomes here is 1, and here is plus omega raised to power 10 is there. Sorry, 5. We have taken 5 as a common, so only 5 is there, because here is 10. Minus 32 omega raised to power 5 as a common, so here is 1. Here is omega raised to power 10. So omega raised to power 5 is there, because omega raised to power 5, omega raised to power 5, both bases are same, so powers can be added. Now here is minus 32, and the value of omega raised to power 5, it can be written as omega cube into omega square, because we already know about what is the value of omega cube. Similarly, omega raised to power 5, here is omega cube into omega square. After that, we have, now put the value of omega cube, that is 1. So it becomes minus 32 omega square. Minus 32 omega square. In the bracket, we have again the value of omega cube is 1. So it becomes 1 plus omega square. 1 plus omega square. Because the value of omega cube is 1. So 1 into omega square, that is omega square. So it becomes 1 plus omega square. So again use this one. 1 plus omega square is equal to minus omega. Put the value here. Its value is minus omega. minus minus plus, that means becomes 32. Omega square into omega, that becomes omega raised to power 3. Again the value of omega cube is 1, so it becomes 32. That is our right hand side. That is our right hand side. Now come to the next question of this worksheet. Okay, now the next one is, if 1 omega omega square are 3 cube roots of unity, then evaluate 3 plus 5 omega plus 3 omega square and its whole square, 1 plus 2 omega plus omega square. We have to find out the value of this. So firstly look at here. Here is 3 plus, you have to split 5 omega into two parts. I will explain it after a few times that why I'm going to split this one. So look at here, 5 omega can be written as 3 omega plus 2 omega. And here is 3 omega square and its whole square. Similarly, separate 2 omega, omega plus omega, and here is omega square. Now look at here is 3 plus 3 omega and 3 omega square. We can take 3 as a common from these 3 values. 3 plus 3 omega plus 3 omega square. Take 3 as a common, so it becomes here is 1 plus omega square. And 2 omega is as it is and its whole square. It's a whole square. Similarly, here is 1 plus omega and omega square. Write it in this way, 1 plus omega plus omega. 1 plus omega plus omega square, and here is omega. 1 omega omega square are the cube roots of unity. That means 1 plus omega square equal to 0. We have to use this result, and the value of omega cube is 1. So, I think you can understand easily that why I have split this one, because in this one we can take 3 as a common and we can use this result. The value of 1 plus omega square is 0. So, put the value here. Here is 3 into 0 plus 2 omega and its whole square. Similarly, its value is 0. So, here is 0 plus omega. So, it becomes 3 into 0. That is 0. So, only 2 omega square is there. So, 2 square is 4 and omega square. And here is 0 plus omega, only omega. So it becomes omega square into omega, that is omega cube. 4 is as it is 4 omega cube. So the value of omega cube is 1. So this result is equal to 4. Hope so that all of you have been clear about in which way we can solve all these types of question of cube root of unity. Now for tomorrow, we will discuss a few questions related to this one. Thank you so much, everyone.